morning students. I hope you are safe and healthy at your home. My name is Rajni Singh, your SST and moral science teacher. Today I am here to discuss our very first chapter, that is Make Differences, in which we will discuss about happiness. So let's start.
Students, Lord Buddha had told that happiness comes when your work and words benefits to others. It means we should not be self-centric all the time. We should think about others, like our parents, neighbors, friends, relatives, classmates, and other surroundings. Nowadays, people run after materialistic things. Adults are chasing for things like building, money, name and fame, whereas students are worried about their marks and for achieving high scores or all materialistic things, they ruin their life. True happiness lies in the small things. Let's understand it with a short story.
Akshay, the apple of everyone's eye, who amongst the other students in class was the smartest and brightest. During his summer vacations, his parents would take him abroad. But Akshay always looked unhappy and upset, finding faults in others and everyone around him, because of which his friends also stopped talking to him. One day, a new student came to his class, Shrey, who became friends with everyone. Shrey was a happy-go-lucky kid. He had no complaints and always found joy in the little things in life. One day, Shrey came and sat next to Akshay.
Hello, I am Shrey and my father just got transferred here. What is your name?
Hi, I am Akshay.
Hello Akshay, what class is it now?
It's mathematics and they may take a surprise test today.
Oh no, I'm not good in mathematics.
Akshay scored the highest marks in class, while Shrey could only score above average. Shrey wasn't very happy with his marks, but wasn't even as sad as Akshay was.
You seem happy with just scoring average marks.
Yes, and you seem to be sad even after scoring 98.
Yeah, I could have got two more marks.
Look at me.
In a few weeks' time, both kids became good friends and Akshay started solving Shrey's maths problems too. He would try to understand the reason for Shrey's happiness. One day, when both of them were going back home, Shrey had a smile on his face. Seeing this, Akshay asked him,
I see that you are smiling most of the time. Why is that?
I don't need a reason to be smiling. I try to find happiness in everything.
Like how?
Now look at this butterfly. Is not it so beautiful? Imagine how different their lives are.
Yeah, it doesn't need to give any exams or even go to school.
And we must head home now. It's getting late.
They came across a beggar on the road and Shrey offered him his favorite biscuit.
Now imagine, they do not have basic clothes to wear, or a house, or even food to eat. We still go to a good school, wear good clothes, and our parents take us for vacations. What more can we wish for?
Yeah, but every parent does that for their kids.
As Shrey was dropping Akshay off at his home, a kid from the neighborhood made fun of Akshay. But Akshay became very angry seeing this. As Akshay was charging towards the kid, Shrey stopped him.
Let me talk to him while you wait here.
As Shrey started talking to the kid, Akshay cooled down and began noticing Shrey. The little kid from neighborhood came and apologized to Akshay.
See, we can always teach a lesson without getting angry. Please don't mind. But I have often seen you getting angry at your own friends too, or else getting very upset over class tests. We are not perfect, are we?
I think you are right. A few days back, I shouted at Akhil for sitting on my seat. Friendship is more important than a seat, right?
So, he apologized to all his friends. And this is how Shrey taught Akshay to be happy for the things we do have and worry less about the things we don't.
So students, you saw in this video that Akshay had everything. He had loving parents who always fulfilled his wishes. He scored well. He had almost everything. But still he was not happy and satisfied with whatever things he had. He used to easily get angry on everything. Whereas Shrey was happy with everything. Even after he scored not well, he had happy life. Just because of his happiness, his surrounding people were also happy. With his presence, he made the happy environment. So students, material doesn't give happiness all the time. It lies in you. With your small gesture of happiness, you can make your surroundings happy and you can have joyful life which you can enjoy with everyone. I hope students, you enjoyed the lesson and you will try to bring happiness in your life and your surroundings as well. Thank you and have a good day.